2 of Grade 12 Docudrama! I am Mrs. Wellsman and I teach the Grade 12 Drama class. All of the drama teachers, Ms. Stasis, Ms. Lusco, Ms. Finley, we're all very proud of the work that these students have done. They choose the topics, research, write the docudramas, and perform them, and they've just done a brilliant job, and realize that the docudramas are all based on truth and fact. They are documentary drama performances. So today you are in for a special treat, because you are here to see Mirror! Lunch in the room, but we have a class in here next period. Please take your garbage with you. Also, try to unwrap all the crinkly stuff now so you're not a distraction to your fellow audience members. I'm also going to ask you to please turn off all
blackberries, blueberries, and anything that goes deep in the dark.
Actors, break a leg!
Welcome to World of Docudrama!
No! Welcome to Lost and Found, the docudrama!
No!
Welcome to Memories!
No!
It's Mirrors!
Oh.
Welcome, everyone, to Mirrors the Docudrama! It's sure to be a fun time, I promise.
Welcome to the greatest docudrama of them all!
That's right!
May our souls encompass you in the eternalized actor's spirit.
May the passions of our fiery performance show you the true meaning of what it is to be entertained.
Theater is a mirror held up to reflect our lives.
What we feel in our hearts, what's important,
and how we see the world.
Mirrors have been used since the 16th century, but back then they were only for the most treasured of nobility.
Wow! Mirrors have been used since 6000 BC, where Pelos obsidian was the preferred choice material.
Wow!
Mirrors are dope. The purest of human essence shown in a great column of luminescent metal.
Mirrors are still dope, yo. Wow.
Hey.
Hey.
So the boss wanted to do some stupid photo shoot for her kids.
Ew, what for?
I don't know, some stupid PR thing. But I'm like, no way am I letting those little things get their fingers all over my Dolce & Gabbana.
Of course not.
Ugh, right? Some people just don't understand.
That clothing is art.
Yes, it is a frequently misunderstood truth.
Honestly, sometimes I think I have to wear a garment bag over my clothes on the way to work just so I don't mess up.
Because the people.
Oh, the people with their grimy hands touching your jacket.
I'm spilling coffee all over my silk shirt.
Honestly, it really ought to be a crime to ruin an outfit like that.
Well, you're not wrong.
It was nice catching up with you.
Oh, you too. Kisses.
Hey, my man! Hey, how you doing? Oh, so,
get that paper in for the boss today.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to hand it in right now.
Not bad. I don't mean to brag or anything, but got it in at 3 o'clock this morning. But on my way down there, you want to know what I heard? I heard Susie from PR. She's sitting there complaining because the boss is giving her hell, reading her the riot act, because she didn't get her deadline in.
Oh my god, you know what they say about employees? They're all equal, but some should be less equal than others.
But I'm sitting there, right, and I'm like, there are guys like you and me sitting here, thinking, doing our work, doing our job, never missing anything, designing this entire place, and people like her have the nerve to complain?
Oh my god, what can you say about people? They're incompetent and unreliable.
You know it! Anyway, you should probably get going, man. I gotta go throw some numbers at those stockholders.
Give them hope for their money, bro.
That's my job, it's what I do.
Hey!
Hi.
How are you?
I'm. How did you know what I was gonna say?
So I'm just gonna go.
I'll see you
later?
Yeah! Okay.
Bye!
Mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
Oh,
you know, it's me, beautiful.
I'm in constant pain. Pain for a leg that isn't even here anymore. They even have a name for it. Phantom limb pain. Maybe I should go from the start. I mean, what's the point in writing down your feelings if you can't understand them, right? Now, things started going wrong the day I was born. My mom, she had a real hard time getting pregnant. The doctors were worried that I'd be born wrong. I was mostly fine, but she wasn't. So, I was raised by my dad, a tough guy, always thinking with his fists. And when he found out his son was born blind, well, I'm not going to talk about that. Flash forward 30 years, and some idiot doesn't think that they have to follow the stop signs. The doctor said they could do nothing to save it. They had to amputate. And now I'm stuck here, feeling pain for a leg that's gone. You know how they fix phantom limb pain? They hold up a mirror to your remaining leg, and seeing it move in the reflection helps relieve the pain from your missing leg. I guess I just can't seem to catch a break.
You know, people often underestimate how important it is, the ability to see yourself in a mirror, the ability to see yourself the way the world perceives you, peek inside the eyes of others. It's fascinating, isn't it? Can you send in Mia, please? Ah, Mia, how was your week?
I hate her! She is mean and controlling, and I don't even want to think about it anymore.
Just the other day, I wrote a poem. It wasn't the greatest poem in the world. I wrote it 6 times before I even thought it was okay. But no, nothing I do is ever good enough for her. I thought mothers were supposed to be able to support you. All she ever does is tear me down.
Yeah. When people have these traits, these traits that we just can't stand, or even these traits that we love, normally, it comes from, well, a place of projection.
Nothing you say makes any sense. God, this is why I hate going to therapy.
Come on, hear me out. There's this saying, you can only see things within others that you can see within yourself. I think the reason that you have such a problem with your mom's controlling and domineering ways is because maybe, just maybe, you don't like those things about yourself.
I'm fine. She's the problem!
Mia, you rewrote that poem, what, 6 times? Before you even found it okay? Now, I'm not saying you have a problem, and I'm not saying you're anything like her. I'm just saying that maybe, just maybe, she isn't the only one that has slightly too high expectations for you.
So I'm turning into my mother. That doesn't explain why I hate this!
You hate this because it's showing you things that you don't want to see. It's telling you truths that maybe you don't want to hear. Maybe that's why it angers you so much.
So my perfection is hiding from my problems?
People aren't just made up of good parts and bad parts, man. Everyone you meet is your mirror. You were telling me about that guy. What's his name? Aaron. Aaron, he shows you the most wonderful of worlds. He writes you the most beautiful of stories. Those are your words, not mine.
What does that have to do with my mother?
It has nothing to do with her. And it has nothing to do with him. But it has everything to do with you. Before you can try and have a relationship with either of them, you need to work on yourself first.
I never said I want to connect with her.
You don't have to. I can see it in the way that you show up here week after week. No matter how many times you say you're through, you're here.
Whatever. I'm leaving.
Wait. Same time next week.
Yeah. I'll be there.
Good.
Out of sync with the image of myself. my god, oh my god, it's all my fault! Am I
what? Well, okay, Echo, slow down. What's going on?
Well, me and Narcissus were talking about Shakespeare's songs when suddenly, out of nowhere!
Okay, whoa! Slow down. Is there a point to this?
Of course there's a point!
Echo, you've called me 3 times this week. Just, what were you saying?
Anyway, as I was saying... Wait, what was I saying?
Echo. My ears are burning.
Echo. She hung up on me.
Oh. Hey there, beautiful.
Beautiful.
What? What? Oh, no. Okay. I was actually talking to myself. Sorry, small mistake. It's okay.
After talking to myself. I have a question. You at the cinema with the...
You're not working with all the facts. It's not your fault. See, I actually have an Instagram photo shoot at 10. So if you could just speed this whole thing up. All right, start again. Go ahead.
I don't know, maybe you want to come and meet movies, kind of know how much you like movies, and I don't know, I like movies, and I love looking at your face, and we could just spend time together looking at each other's face. That's your face, kind of love your face.
Okay, sorry. I'm going to stop you one more time. I don't speak, what is it they speak when you're from? Ah, yes! Geek. So, I'm afraid you're kind of wasting my beautiful time here.
Beautiful. Emma. It's Echo. And I just want to know if you wanted to come with me to the movies, that's all.
Emma. Echo. Emilio. Esteban? All the same to me. I'm sorry. But more importantly, you can't go on a date with all this. For the same reason that you shouldn't be able to look at all this. You're just, as the French say, unattractive. Sorry.
Attractive?
Yeah, but you're a real smart cookie. So, I was wondering if you could help me write my essay on Shakespeare.
It's Shakespeare, and I can't believe I ever care about such a self-obsessed egomaniac who can't even remember the name of one of the greatest playwrights in the world.
Okay. I can see that there's been some miscommunication. Got off on the wrong foot, all right? So I have one of Narcy Baby's classic ideas. Why don't you write it for me?
Really?
I knew you'd like it!
How stupid do you have to be to try manipulating me with Shakespeare? I can't believe you're such an idiot with such a god couple.
Sorry, let us document this. We'll send it to you later, don't worry. So, I'm thinking you're gonna write my essay now.
Anything for you, Narcy Baby.
Oh, that's so kind of you, Esteban. So much.
Bye.
Toodles. Women, am I right?
You know that feeling you get? That feeling when you reach out in a hall of mirrors?
Reach out. Not sure if you're going to touch anything or not.
Not sure if you're going to reach out and touch the ice-cold touch of silver denial
or the vacancy of dead still melancholic air.
It's ironic, isn't it, that neither option seems appealing?
That neither seem to give any.
That's just life,
isn't it?
Life is the hall of mirrors.
Life is the uncertainty of each step.
The uncertainty of the possibility of absolute retaliation, meaning each trudge forward.
But, like the hall of mirrors,
check your steps.
Don't put all your weight behind each movement,
and you'll find that your path forward is clear as day.
Polish yourself, and like the mirror, you'll become what you want.
Come on,
do it!
Do it! Are you chicken? You gotta kill me!
Bloody Mary!
Come on! Do it!
Bloody Mary!
You gotta get Jess!
Bloody Mary! Bloody Mary! Strange, huh? How we let 2 little words cause such fear. I mean, alone they're nothing special, and yet, somehow we all know what it means. Stand in front of a mirror, call for her 3 times, and she'll appear. And why do we do a silly ritual that can cause such fear when it's so dark, twisted,
I mean, in the beginning, it used to be innocent and beautiful. Little girls would rush downstairs at midnight, stand in front of a mirror, light a candle. And in the reflection, they'd see the face of their future husband staring back at them. So why, if it's changed, if it's become so dark, do we still do it today? Why did we do it in the first place? I mean, why do we let a mirror hold such power over us? It's just a mirror, just glass. They're just words.
They're in our schools, our homes, our gyms.
When you look into one, you look into a world of uncertainty. You never know what you might find.
Beauty.
Vanity.
Love.
Hate.
Truth.
Or lies.
I know it's just me looking at my reflection. It looks just like me, but it isn't.
That color really looks good on you.
That color makes you look fat.
The new haircut suits you.
I should really go and ask for a refund for that haircut.
You look really good.
I wouldn't go outside looking like that.
It's like someone's talking back to me. But it isn't just one person. I don't know. They're like telling me you're kind.
Your nose is too big.
You're thoughtful.
You should really get to the gym.
You're smart.
You should really change all that.
Why isn't it enough just to be myself? I know I'm not
perfect.
But why does it matter? What I wear? If I put my hair bun everywhere? Red or pink lipstick or any makeup at all.
That I need big bulging biceps and a six pack. And if I wear pink, people might think I'm gay. Or if I cry, somehow it makes me less of a man.
Jesus Christ, look at you. You're so vain. Week after week, staring in the mirror, acting like anything's gonna be different.
You don't have to be so hard on yourselves.
You know, I've been trying to get a list together of everything that's wrong with you, and it's a really long list.
You don't have to tear yourselves down.
If I'm saying this to you, imagine what everybody else in this room is thinking.
It doesn't matter what they think. It matters what you think.
I'm here for you.
They can't seem to grasp that I'm
brave.
Weak.
Strong.
Full of
anxiety. That I don't look a certain way.
Well, that I'm too scared, and all it shows me is
beauty.
Vanity.
Love.
Hate.
Truth.
Lies.
But in the end,
it's just a mirror.
All it really shows you is
the good.
The bad.
And your reality.
Hey, let's go!
What are you wearing?
I'm fine. Shut off.
5, 4, 3, 2.
You dream of traveling to wondrous new places. Is your daughter prettier than you?
Are you just that good looking?
If so, come down to Mirrors Incorporated. You may have heard of our work.
We helped the evil queen get rid of her dreadful little stepdaughter and get her happy ending.
Well, didn't she die?
Oh, well, aren't you just precious? Anyway, you may have heard of this satisfied customer. Here's Alice.
God, we don't pay him enough.
Oh my God.
Alice!
I'm Alice. I was very satisfied with my trip through the looking glass. If you call now, you could be happy too.
You were high. Oh
God, I wish.
Okay! Very creative imagination. Love it. Love the enthusiasm.
Right.
Anyways, if you call now, we will throw in a free pair of talking mirrors. Side effects may include nausea, soul splitting, headaches, and in rare cases, death. By purchasing a mirror, you enter a legally binding contract that waives all your basic human rights away and leaves you accountable for what may or may not occur.
Hey, that's very illegal.
That's business. Call now.
Funhouse Mirror. mirrors show reflections that show alternate realities. As you continue on, each reflection shows a different augmented reality.
How much work today?
Work's work. How was your day?
Good. Jerry's helping out in the office again.
Jerry was helping you at the office.
Can we not, please? Can we just watch the movie?
It's fine.
You know, mirrors aren't just for looking at your reflection or seeing the car behind you. They can also be used in medical practices, and though you should probably be careful, because they can cause hallucinations.
What? What are you doing?
Oh, I just have to send a quick email for work with Jerry.
It's always an email for work with you now. What happened to when work was there and we were here?
It's not my fault. Jerry and I have to get the report ready for the boss tomorrow.
I see. It's with Jerry. Again. Of course, he's so helpful, isn't he?
Can we just watch the movie?
Fine, whatever.
And before there were mirrors, people just had to look at the reflection in a clear, like, pool of water. But as you can imagine, it didn't really work out well, as views were often very distorted.
What a crappy and ham-fisted way to talk about mirrors.
I know. What do you think you're doing?
Checking my phone.
Your phone, yeah. What, your notifications?
Yeah, what is possibly wrong with that?
You know what's wrong with
that? No.
Give it to me.
Excuse me?
Give it to me!
Okay, that is not...
Oh, Karen, we gotta get together. We gotta work on the report due next week. Love, Jerry. What is this, some kind of code?
It's not a code, it's exactly what it means. We have to work on a report.
Oh, yeah, right? Okay. Always with him. Didn't I tell you to stop talking to him?
It's not my fault. We're co-workers. I don't have a choice if I work with him or not.
Yes, but you have a choice if he's here with us in our living room.
You are being ridiculous. I am not cheating on you. I've never cheated on you. Nothing is going on between me and Jerry.
Maybe, but you're tearing us apart. And I don't trust you. I don't. I know you're cheating on me. I'm done with you.
What do we got here? Jerry on Instagram.
Just Instagram.
That is a cute puppy, Karen. But not as cute as you. Oh, Jerry on Snapchat.
Okay, it's Snapchat.
My God, his lake house is nice. You guys should go there. Okay. Away from us and our life together.
Okay, come on. Please, I can explain this.
Jerry on text.
Okay, no.
What time do you go to bed? Can I call you? Don't bother.
Jerry. I don't know what happened. He stormed out. He thinks we're sleeping together or something, and he just left, and I don't know what to do.
He just found out about us.
Yeah, he stormed out. Yeah.
Oh, Catherine, I'm so sorry. Want me to come over? You don't deserve to be alone.
I don't know. Maybe I do. Yeah.
Funhouse mirrors show reflections that show different realities. As you continue on, each shows you a different augmented reality that ultimately arrives at the same conclusion.
You know, when you're little, a baby, age 3, 4, 5, mirrors are this magical, magical thing. You can look into them and you see yourself. That's me, myself, staring back at me. And then you get a little older, age 7, 8, 9, and there's this magical, beautiful thing. They're transporting you to far-off kingdoms, making you feel like a princess or a knight, and you think, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? And then you're a little older, age 15, 16, 17, and suddenly it's not just me staring back at me. It's me, my friends, and my family. It's all of us together thinking about our past and our future, and I just think, are we going to keep reflecting the sins of our past, or will we finally reflect into the future?
They always lie, you know? They always say that we've learned, that we've changed, that we would never dare repeat our actions. Yet the walls of tyranny remain present in our world, ready to ensnare the next prey, the next enslaved, the next oppressed.
1914, Ottoman Empire.
The Armenian Genocide to this day disputed, to this day unacknowledged.
Committing genocide, as someone called, is no more than anti-Turkish propaganda.
The existence of this genocide is no more than Armenian propaganda.
The American government to this day has yet to acknowledge this genocide. The forgotten genocide. The forgotten lives. The forgotten losses.
1.5 million dead, still disputed, systematically murdered, unrecognized. Never forget.
But we've learned, right? We've changed. We've seen our actions. We would never dare repeat them.
Nazi Germany, 1941.
The Holocaust, even the name of which inspires mourning and sadness.
The final solution was never the extermination of the Jewish people, just the deportation.
Gas chambers were never used. That is simply a myth perpetrated by the Jewish people to discredit the Germans.
But we've seen the signs. We've seen our mistakes. We've changed. We would never dare repeat them.
6 million dead, systematically murdered, unrecognized. Never forget.
The Rwandan genocide, 1994, only 24 years ago. So what have we learned in this so-called modern age? Who did we change? Did we do a damn thing?
There's no such thing as one-sided genocide. Accounts as such are overblown and nonsensical.
Many were killed on both sides of this genocide, making those who carried it out and their enemies morally equivalent.
Now forgive me if I don't pat the human race on the back. Forgive me if I don't congratulate us on our grand success. Almost a century and we still don't know how to keep ourselves alive. Almost a century and we still can't read the signs. Almost a century and we let revisionists change the narrative that is history. We've seen this before. Don't let all that is left be the lies.
You may think Mira's as infallible.
Depicting our past.
Predicting our future.
Enchanted possessions possessing powers beyond comprehension.
They tear me down. They build us up. But if I'm just a mirror of others, then
who am I?
The reflections are
infinite.
You might think this, but really it's glass.
An inanimate object.
And I'm not going to let some shiny, polished surface tell me how I'm going to live my life.
Decide where I go and who's going with me.
How I'm
going
to change the world.
Leave it better than I found it.
At the end of the day, I'm in charge.
I'm the one in control.